before being taken on set now. Let's just take a moment to remember. 10 weeks ago, these guys were just at the show, now they're in the show. So they've gone from people just into actors in being on the That's one of the strange things about the film is you get up one morning and say, well, you're going to do a carpet for you. It's the same corridor. And that's one of the tricks we use as filmmakers, is we reuse our material. So if you don't have the other end of the corridor, the film becomes a direction to create an entire corridor in the mind of the viewer. When you see the film is announced today, in the we've also got our DP here, director of photography with the camera. On set, we also have a sound guy, and we have a man in charge of production design, in charge of costume, makeup, featuring. There's a whole machine here that would only be focused on getting everybody on set in costume, in the right moment, in the right frame of mind. Now, of course, that means everybody has to be very, very professional. And every actor who comes on a movie set, they really are at the top of their game at that point. They don't want to forget their lines, they don't want to make a mistake. So, you know what? There's no pressure on these guys to get it wrong. We have to get this right in the first page on every single shot. One of the other tools that we have as filmmakers is sound design. And what I think you'll notice when you watch what we're shooting is it's very artificial. But the moment it's put into context with the other shots and edited and has the music and sound effects, then it becomes all very real. And it really seals the illusion. So, we have our cannon fodder, our rebel cannon fodder here, rocking. In the film business, it's where we bring the actors on the set and we step through the physical machine of what this sequence is going to be about so that everybody knows where they're going to be. Now, for actors, what this is really about is where do I need to stand in the best light to show the camera my face. So you'll often see actors turning to camera and giving them the best sight. Some actors, I've worked with actors who will only turn around a particular way because their nose looks good this way or doesn't look good this way. It's a strange business. And so we're walking the scene now where our assistant directors are working through with the actors and we're going to figure out the mechanics of this shot. Now the first thing you'll notice is we've only got one set here. We don't have the other wall, but we don't need that because if there were another wall, the camera wouldn't be able to see the actors. So that's one of the first illusions that you're going to see is that very often filmmaking is about what you don't see. The moment we see the rest of the set, we have here, we all see that there is, you know, walls and balances and all sorts of stuff around the set. But the camera is surrounded by this little flat box here, and it can only see the set. And that helps to create the illusion. The other thing that we're going to do is, in this sequence, which is set on the spaceship is going to be hit by some laser blasts. So, take one. And look, hold start, everyone first positions. And action. Fantastic! Give her a round of applause! Wow! Wait till you see that in the final movie. It's going to be